been out on the boat several times actually this year. Today I'm hopeful I can at least catch some bass, maybe crappie. There is some shad running also. That's a possibility. Let's see if we can get some luck today. Happy fishing, everybody. Please stay on. I'm gonna find out what you are right now. It's a bass. Oh, God. I have to downsize my hooks because I've been getting bites. But, oh, I'm shaking a little bit. Because it's been a hard start for me. I've been out on the water for a couple times. And the fish would just get a good bite and I felt really good weight. But they would get off. I think it's because my hook was too big and the tail on my swim baits were just too long. This is a beauty. 2-pound bass. Thank you. Jump start my spring fishing with a nice bass. 2-pounder, 15 inches long. Beautiful color. Downsized to a tiny square bill. This is by Begley. I tried using kind of like a slender shad, but they come back too fast back to the boat. They swim too fast. So if you want to fish with a square bill, it's nice because you feel the tension as you pull it back to the boat, reel it in, and it does this really fast fishing action. And this big bass got it, just barely on the rear hook. Hold on. Small problem about this lure is it's so small that it could turn on itself when you cast. That's one minus. When I cast it, it just makes a light splash, which is nice. It doesn't spook the fish away. That's the advantage of a smaller square bill crankbait. If you use a bigger one, bigger splash. But I guess it depends what kind of effect you want, how the fish are reacting. See that right now? The lure turned on itself, so it's just spinning in the water. That is not the effect I want. So I'd say that happens about 25% of the time I cast. Those are not good odds. Snagged on some sort of fabric under the water. If I can just grab it. Ah! Whoa. Yeah, this was not gonna come out on its own. That was in there really good. But you're not gonna take my lure. Blanket or some sort. Come on. Oh, got it. Saved. Oh, got another one. Oh, God, this is beautiful. This is a beauty. Oh god, this is bigger than the last one. Stay on there. I think it's hooked pretty well. Oh, I just saw it come up and it was like, womp. Oh man, this is the day. Gotcha. Oh, this is giant. I had to switch back to my spinnerbait because I wasn't getting any action from the small begley anymore. Whoa, look at this beauty. There's heft to this. I'm gonna say it's 3 pounds. Wow, that was a cool catch. I couldn't get it on camera, but I was pulling it just up to the boat, 3 feet away, and this bass went sideways and took it. Definitely spawning. Look how beautiful that is. Good day for bass. 16 3/4. 16 3/4. Yes. Yes. Okay. I'll let you go. Beautiful. I saw you last year. You're still living here? You survived the winter, all right. Yeah. Feels like a bass. Oh, nice jump. Yeah, come on in. Come on in. Yeah, bass day. Awesome. Oh, come to Papa. Oh, they're so big today. Huge. This is a good one too. Got a home run today, yes. Beautiful bass. Oh, I knew you were gonna do that. Ah. Just stay there for a second. Why you little? Stop curling. Straighten out. 13 inches. But beautiful. Let you go. Breathing? Yes, I think you are. Yes! Hey everybody. So it turned out to be a good day. A great start for spring fishing. Well, if you have any stories about bass fishing starting out the season, please feel free to give me a comment on my page. Please subscribe, please like, and we'll see you next time. I think it's a shad. Ooh. For a shad. I came here to look for shad. This is the first one.